H, J, K, L, and M are points on the circumference of a circle with center O, M, K is the diameter of the circle and it's parallel to H, J. M, J is equal to J, L, and angle J, M, K is 38 degrees. So we have to given a reason why angle H, J, M is 30 degrees. And we see that the line MK and HJ are parallel. So it is 38 because alternating angles. See the Z? So the angles in a joint will be equal, so HJM is also 38 degrees because they are alternating angles. Right, why M? JK is 90 degrees, right? So we see that MK,
the angle N is every circle, is the right angle.
Right? So the angle in a semicircle is form a right angle. That's why MJK is 90 degrees. Determine the value of each of the following angles, showing details working where appropriate. So you have to find angle MLG. So angle M. LJ is this angle right here, right? So we could find angle MKJ because of the triangle, and it's in a triangle add up to 180 degrees. So MKJ will be equal to 180 degrees minus 38 plus 90. Because there's the other angles in this triangle. Right? So 180 degrees minus 128 degrees. Which is equal to 52 degrees. Right, angles in a triangle add up to 180. Right, and MLG, so MKJ is 52, so MLG is 52 because.
Angles obtained from an arc to different points on the circumference are always equal. What about the circle?
LJ is equal to 52 degrees. Angles obtained from an arc are always equal. Yes, and the subtended in the same segment of a circle. Now we have to find angle LJK. Oh, right. So we didn't write a reason for MKJ, which is angle in a triangle add up to 180 degrees. Nice. So angle LJK. So let's see where angle LJK is. angle L, G, K. So it's this angle right here. You see that? Angle L, G, K. So we need to find that little angle there. So, how do we think we could find that angle? This is a little piece. We know this whole thing is 90 degrees. So, we want to find this small piece of it. So, think about it. What do you all think we can do to get this angle right here? Right, so we know angle LMG is 52 degrees. Because the isosceles triangle, LMG is 52 degrees because it's an isosceles triangle and the angles are equal. So we can find, there are several ways we could do this. So we can find angle, right? So you find angle LMK, which is 52 degrees minus 38, which you get 14 degrees, right? So we find angle LMK, which is 14 degrees, and angle LJK is equal to 14 degrees also. Why? Because angles subtended from the same segments of a circle are equal. All about the circle theorem. So now we have to find angle GHM. So let's see where GHM is. Okay, so we write in 14. GHM, right, is this angle on top here. Right? So how do you think we could find GHM? Which theorem would we use? So watch it. So we see a cyclic quadrilateral. So GHM will be 180 degrees minus 52 degrees because the angle opposite is 52
degrees. Add up to 180 degrees.
So GHM is equal to 128 degrees. Why? Because opposite angles in a cyclic quadrilateral add up to 180. So angles, the angle opposites add up to 180, so 180 minus 52 will give you GHM. Any questions? Write in the comment below. Hope you all understand.
All about the CSEC Maths June. All about the CSEC Maths June.